Good morning, students. So today we will be solving exercise 5.3 of class 6 mathematics. Exercise 5.3 of NCERT book of class 6. First question is, match the following. So there are two columns given. In the first column it is written straight line, second right angle, third acute angle, fourth obtuse angle, fifth reflex angle. And another column is A less than 1/4 of a revolution, less than 1/4 of a revolution, more than half a revolution, C is 1/4 of a revolution, D is 1/2 a revolution, D is 1/4 of a revolution, E 1/4 and 1/2 of a revolution, F 1 complete revolution. Now before we do this, for the students, those who are not able to understand at the first go, this primary discussion will help them. Straight line is the angle which is formed at any point in a straight line. So angle formed at any point in a straight line is 180 degree. Okay, it's called a straight line. Right angle means straight line will be like this and it will always be 180 degree. Right angle will be 90 degree. Acute angle should be less than 90 degree. Obtuse angle should be more than 90 degree. And reflex angle is the angle on the other side of the acute angle. If this is acute angle, then reflex angle will be the opposite side of that. This is the reflex angle. Now in case of a complete angle, say if it is a complete angle and say if this is 90 degree, so this shows right angle and the opposite of this, this whole part shows reflex angle. So this is the basic which is required. Now straight line. Straight line means half of a revolution. So they are talking in context to clock. Previous exercise was based on clock. So half a revolution. Say if it is a clock, 12, 3, 6, 9, 1, 2, 4, 5, 7, 8, 10 and 11. Say if the hour's hand is in 3 and if it undergoes half revolution, then what angle will it form? It will form 180 degree. That means a straight angle, which is 180 degree, means half a revolution. Okay. Next is right angle. Right angle will be 1/4 of a revolution. If you will take 1/4 of any revolution, example, where would you like to keep the hour's hand? Let it be in 12. Let this be at 12. Now, after every 5 divisions, there is one number given. Now, it is said right angle. So, if you take 5, 10 and 15 minutes, so 15 minutes divided by the overall 60 minutes is equal to 1/4. What I mean to say is, if you move 15 minutes and overall minute in a clock, if it moves throughout the whole circle, it will assume 60 minutes. So it will be equal to 1/4. So move it from here to here. So this 90 degree will correspond to 90 degree, that means right angle will correspond to 1/4 of a revolution. Similarly, acute angle will be less than 1/4 of a revolution. Obtuse angle will be more than half revolution. And reflex angle will be between 1/4 and 1/2 of a revolution. Between 1/4, that means this is 1/4 and this is 1/2. So between this, whatever angle is there, this will be the reflex angle. So for first you can write A, for first you can write D, for second you can write, no, for first you will write C, then second you will write D, then third will be equal to A, and fourth will be B, and fifth will be E. So either you can match like this or you can match with the help of arrow. In the exam, if you want to match it in less time, then this technique will help, because if you note down in the exam, this will kill time. So in the exam, you can simply write down the Roman numerals and match the correct alphabets. That will be the faster method. While you practice in your classwork notebook, then you may write down like this, but in the exam you can simply write like this. But take care that when Roman number has to be written, write Roman number. Not write the algebraic, do not write the 1, 2, 3, 4 the way it is written like this. You know? If it is written in the Roman format, then write in the Roman format. Do not write in the Arabian format. Now we'll do the next question. Exercise 5.3 NCERT class 6. Question number 2. Classify each of the following as right angle, straight angle, acute angle, obtuse angle or reflex angle. So first one is drawn like this. A. Since this is less than 90 degree, it will be acute angle. Next one is like this. Since this is more than 90 degree, this will be obtuse angle. This should be less than 90 degree. This should be more than 90 degree. This was question number B. Question number C. The angle indicated is this one. This is when you draw an angle like this and show like this, that means it is right angle, that means 90 degrees. So it is right angle. Then next is D. If this would have been the angle, I would have said acute, but this is not the angle which is given in the book. In the book, the angle which is indicated is this one. This is reflex angle. This is reflex angle, this part. This part is acute, but it is not asked. E. This is an angle, this is an angle, and this is also an angle. In the book, indication is this angle. So this angle is what? Straight angle. This is a straight angle. Next is F. This angle and this angle. Very clearly it is acute angle. Both are acute angles. That's it for exercise 5.3. So every day we will not get a number of questions. There will be sometimes less number of questions, sometimes there will be more number of questions. So today it was less number of questions. So very happy situation for you all. Enjoy. That's it. I will come up with exercise 5.4 in the next class.